It's 8 years now since Bowie died, and as I said, it all went to shit the moment he died. That is no coincidence. Everything went to shit the moment David Bowie died. Anyway, commemorating him, here we are. Anyway, so the first thing is, we've got Table House, which is Alan here, who's going to do a song on piano and voice. And tragically, last night I was quite pissed. And I thought I could sing Life on Mars and said I would do that. And realised that I was about 15 when I could do that. That's really high notes, and I'm fucking 63, so we'll see. I'm going to try and do that, but I'll probably cock it up. So anyway, ladies and gentlemen, starmen, young and old dudes, Table House, Alan.
Because we've never done this before.
No, I've never done it.
Okay.
Here we go. Right, let's try this.
Okay.
It's a beautiful small affair to the girl with the messy hair. But her mommy is yelling out, and her daddy is told her to go. But her friends are nowhere to be seen. She walks through her sunken dream to the sea with the clearest view. Now she's hooked to a silver screen, but the film is a saddening bore. She's lived it 10 times or more. It's about to be read again as they ask her to focus on sailors fighting in the
tones. How far down are we going to go? Yeah, we're going for verse 2 then. It's all very made up as you go along.
It's on America's touch of ground. Mickey Mouse is on the pound. And the workers have struck for fame. Because Lennon's on sale again. See the mice in their million holes. To the Norfolk Broads, Rule Britannia is out of bounds. To my mother, my dog, and clown. But the film is a saddening bore. Cause I wrote it 10 times or more. It's about to be written today. As I ask you to focus on sleep, fighting. While we're on the outro, I'll just mention who's playing here. So next we have Rob Clysell here and Lennon, aka Cam.
Life on Mars, and I've been working on the one that Nirvana also made famous, The Man Who Sold the World, and I've never kicked it before, so I'm well out of my comfort zone, but I'm going to give it a go, and here we go.
Thank you.
gazed upon the stair and spoke of was and when, although I wasn't there. He said I was his friend, which came as some surprise. Long, long time ago. Who knows? Not me. We never lost control. Your face to face with the man who sold the world. Shook his hand and made my way back home. I searched for form and land. For years and years I roamed. I gazed a gazely stare at all the millions there. We must have died alone a long, long time ago. Control your face to face with the man who sold the world. Who knows? Not me. Your face to face with the man who sold the world. Control your face to face with the man who sold the world. Thank you very much. I wish I could do more, but it will be David Bowie. So thank you very much, Kev.
Table House, Alan Whittingham.
Thanks, Alan.
That is lovely. Because it is a kind of short set of things. Rob, are you going to play and then talk about that theme?
Yeah.
So, right. All right. Pay attention now, pay attention. fucking hell. They're not paying attention. But this is, over here, this is Rob Clydesdale, who a lot of you know as the, well, not just the Hapsley engineer with me and this Kevolution thing, but from 3D Echo. And he's also played with some geezer called Bowie. More importantly, with me as well. That was his defining moment in my book. And something called Defoe with some geezer over there called Daniels. So he and Cam here, otherwise AKA Lemon, are going to do a couple of songs, and then Rob's going to tell you about the time when he and 3D Echo worked with Bowie in Switzerland in Montreux, wasn't it? Yeah, in Australia, my beautiful laundrette, which is we actually have a direct connection here. But anyway, so and then I'll play some of the songs that Rob did with Mr. Bowie. So anyway, over to you two.
Show.
Say it anyway because it's this kind of day, but basically I had a band called 3D Echo, and in 1993 we went to Queen's studio in Montreux in Switzerland to record an album in July 1993 with Dave Richards, who was one of Queen's producers and co-produced with them a lot of stuff, and we had free time. We had a whole month's free time. And so we went over there, scraped some money together. We were all on the dole at the time. And 2 weeks into our recording, we recorded 5 songs. And then all of a sudden we were told that our session needed to be cut short. So because David Bowie had to come in and record some music for a 4-part miniseries on BBC Two called Buddha of Suburbia. So, our manager said, hey, well, how about getting these guys as session musicians on the show? So that's kind of what happened. And what happened was that Bowie said that he would listen behind the live room door as we were having a jam. And if he liked what he heard, then he'd come in and introduce himself. And if he didn't, then he'd bugger off. So anyway, we started having a jam, and then all of a sudden, who walked through the door but David Bowie? Yeah. And I haven't even told you, I don't think. This is my son, you know. So I feel quite awkward saying this, especially in such a public environment. So I'm just staring at the floor. Anyway, he came in, he introduced himself to us, and then on the following Monday, we started working on bits and pieces of the Buddha of Suburbia show. And it wasn't even an album at the time. It was just bits and pieces of music throughout the show. He said to us, right, can you do this kind of beat? Can you do this kind of bass? And drums went down, bass went down. Then I did some guitar. And he said, can you just do some sort of like rhythmical thing? So I just went. And then after that, he said, do some lead guitar over it. And then I was expecting to be working there for hours and hours.
but he took the very first take of everybody, which turned me thinking, well, if that's all that's needed at that level, then I can adopt that in my recordings. And so I've done that ever since. If it's not the first take, it's the second or third take. But that's the way you do it, because it keeps it fresh. Do you know what I mean? So, yeah, fucking too right. So I learned a fucking big lesson from that guy, and that's what I'm thankful for. And I've just mullered one of his songs, so I'm going to muller... Well, we're going to muller another one, aren't we?
And liking him in my youth, and still do. Very clever musician. And when I was asked to do this, the first thing you think of when you think of David Bowie is the ukulele, obviously, don't you? What else would you think of? Well, that's the way my brain works, and because this is a ukulele, it's not a cricket bat, it's not a baseball bat, it's an electric ukulele, in case you're wondering. years. You spoke of was and when, although I wasn't there. You said I was his friend, which came as some surprise. I spoke into his eyes, I thought you died alone. Just said keep going with that chord sequence at the end, and I had to think of a way of ending it, so I did keep going a little bit and then I ended it like that. Anyway, that was Man Who Sold the World on ukulele, probably the first time it's ever been done.
Right, over there. Quivering Lip.
And I Here it goes, man and wife. Touch the fan, so you left a note far beyond the fringe. I don't recall exactly what you wrote on it. Something about eating the last biscuit. At Christmas and doll, take what you need, but don't leave me a note. Tomorrow is another day. Who may? I need you fierce, I need you keen. As we lay on our black satin sheets, listen to Dubwembe and Segovia. You start to wriggle when I try to get too close to you. You like it too, you like it too. One, one for me. Yes, you are the one. You are the one.
Ladies and gentlemen, clap a lot for Mr. Neil Gowans.
Let me put my arms around your head. Do your time, let's go to bed. Don't forget to turn out the light. Don't laugh, baby, it'll be alright. Call me out another phone. We'll ring and see if your friends are home. Perhaps the strange ones in the dome need a super we can read up alone and try to get it on the line once before. People stared in Jagger's eyes and scored like the video films we saw. And his name was always Buddy. And she shrugged and asked to stay. She'd sigh like, take the wonder kid and turn her face away. She's uncertain if she likes him, but she knows she really loves him. It's a crash course for the ravers. It's a drive in Saturday. Uniform and pray to work. Neither hands nor limbs will burst. Hard enough to keep formation in this fallout saturation. Cursing at the astronaut that's imagining shield in his cabinet. You're a supply with Sylvian. You're a supply with Diamond. Leaves us as it heads down to the shore. Shrug and ask to stay. She'd sigh like, drink the wonder kid and turn her face away. She's uncertain if she likes him, but she knows she really loves him. It's a crash course for the ravers. It's a drive in Saturday. And his name was always Buddy. And she shrugged she'd sigh like trick the wonder kid and turn her face away. She's uncertain if she likes him, but she knows
she really loves him. It's a crash course for the Raiders. It's a drive in Saturday. It's a drive in Saturday. It's a drive in Saturday.
Angry black stars and all that stuff. So let's hear it. Here we go.
Smarty Jimmy was the captain of the city, strung out on lasers, slack hat raising, ain't on your raisins, pulling the wheel. New York to go, go, taste that poor old green. She loves him, but just for a short while she'll scratch in the sand. But let go of his hand. Says he's a beautician, sells you nutrition, keeps all your dead hair from making up underwear. Poor little queenie. Travis Mojo lights on the neon, sits in a capsule. Loves to be alive. Loves to be
Job of it, and I kind of find myself kind of going halfway between David and Iggy's versions. Well, you can judge. I should have.
Good night, Starman. Fame, Space Odyssey,
everything, singing.
Back to a prize if anyone can list all.
I hear the Killers, Mr. Brightside, I think, fuck you. Because their fans don't fucking know.
Come, get you.
It could be me.
Diamond Dogs album. David's more experimental pieces.
Rebel, 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 rebel.
Alice with the legendary Mark Plunder. And then it's me with my Bowie Disco.
Yay!
This is going to be a fucking frenzy.
Woo!
Right. Guess what this one is? Think about the Berlin Wall. Drive them away. We can That's us. Thank you. But anyway, so having said, Looking Glass Alice with another the legendary Mark Plunder of McTell's, TVP's, and all sorts of other kinds of plays, and Harry, like Tim Boss, he's in every fucking band now, from Neil Gowans and the Winos and everything else. So right, so shout a lot for Looking Glass Alice, and then I'll do the disco thing.
Yeah. for having us.
Looking Glass Alice, ladies and gentlemen, fucking hell. This is quite big. Put this in your diaries that you saw of these two here. 'Cause they're gonna be